I mean, genuine love is, well, attachment says, you know, I love you, therefore I want you to make me happy. And genuine love says, I love you, therefore I want you to be happy. If that includes me, great. If it doesn't include me, I just want your happiness. And so it's a very different feeling. You know, attachment is like holding very tight, but genuine love is like holding very gently, nurturing, but allowing things to flow, not to be held tightly. The more tight we hold on to others, the more we will suffer. But it's very hard for people to understand that, because they think that the more they hold on to someone, the more it shows that they care about them. But it's not. It's really just that they're trying to grasp at something because they're afraid that otherwise they will they themselves will be hurt. Any kind of relationship which imagines that we can fulfill ourselves through another is bound to be very tricky. I mean, ideally, people should come together already feeling fulfilled within themselves and just therefore appreciating that in the other, rather than expecting the other to supply that sense of well-being which they don't feel on their own. Then there's a lot of problems. And also along with the projection, which comes with romance, where we project all our ideals and desires and romantic fantasies onto the other, which the other cannot possibly fulfill. Once you get to know them, you recognize that it's not Prince Charming or Cinderella. It's just, you know, a very ordinary person also struggling. And unless one is able to see them with, to like them as well as feel desire for them, and to also have loving kindness and compassion, then it's going to be a very difficult relationship.
I had a therapist tell me once, it was ironic how much love I gave out, because I didn't give much to myself. She laughed, like self-love was a sick joke. I chuckled, then cried at home. I had someone tell me once I could not love anyone else until I learned to love myself. This time I got to laugh. This time the sick joke was mine, it was me. Might as well wait forever. I remember hating myself at the age of 7. Journals filled to the brim with criticisms by 8. I had enough pages to stitch them into wings, to fly close enough to the sun to see my tears turn to steam, felt the wax burn on my shoulders and mold into thick skin. I was 9 when I wanted to die. 13 when I found a solution, figured if I could cut my legs enough, gravity would let me go. When it didn't, I tied a pillowcase around my neck, twisting like the rope swings I knew so well from childhood. Heard my heartbeat pound in my ears like a warning drum, then fade. I'd almost convinced myself I'd done it. When I started writing, I smeared my blood on every page to remind myself that everything beautiful has a consequence. I'd hoped to stall the clotting long enough to give myself to the craft and let myself go. I have died so many times. So when I told you that loving you almost makes life worth it, I was not joking. When I tell you that loving you almost makes me forget how much I hate myself, it is not poetry. Loving you is taking all the love I could never give myself and putting it to good use. It is reminding myself that if someone can love a dying thing this way, can hold the Lazarus of my body and give thanks for the way it holds back, If someone can kiss the scars, administer the pills, absorb the bad days, and wake up smiling next to me, then I can try to breathe again. Because self-love does not always come first, or second, or even ever. But your love be the guardrail on the ledge, be the drawers that hide all the sharp things, be the body that carries my collapsed frame into bed, be the flowers you bought. Because even though they are dying too, they still dance. Love will not heal me, will not wipe my slate of a body clean. I will always be a woman of wounds, of rope-marked neck and melted skin. Love will not heal me, but it will hold my hand if I ever heal myself, and maybe teach me a joke that I can stay alive long enough to laugh at. I love you. Enough to want to love myself, too.
We have one question from the social media, the Facebook. Amit Madan wants to know, in this materialistic age, the real feeling of love is disappearing from our life. Most of the love we receive from others and express to others is superficial. How can we reinforce the real feeling of love in our own life and in others?
Forget about others. If you learn to be loving by your own nature, not because of somebody else or something else. I know the question is coming from Facebook, there's an enormous possibility. You can even love those people who don't even exist. So I'm saying it's a tremendous possibility. So if you just become love, not love somebody, then you will know the nature of love. If you love somebody, it's a fickle happening, because no human being will happen 100% the way you want them. Every human being on this planet is going to disappoint you, believe me. Not because they'll do something wrong, because nobody can fulfill the unrealistic expectation you have of them, it's simply not possible. Have you been able to fulfill anybody's expectation, I'm asking you, entirely? Partially, but never entirely, isn't it? So nobody else will be able to do it. Unless you're still such a hopeless romantic, you're still waiting, that ideal person is going to come from somewhere. No, believe me, whoever comes, I want you to know, the ideal people whom you worship, when Krishna was there, his wives complained. All right?
So there is no hope for us. Yes, please remember this.
What do I think love means? That's a good question. What do I think love means? I compare love to, it's so funny, so many metaphors with garden and plants and love and life. I compare love to a garden, and specifically, an individual plant in that garden. When you go to plant certain things, whether it be flowers, food, trees, whatever the case may be, you go into it thinking that you want to make sure that the garden that you're essentially putting this seed to grow in, you want to make sure that the garden is cleared off, clean, you know, free of pesticides, toxins, garbage, everything. You want to make sure that the soil is sustainable for life. And then you want to make sure that you have the right idea going in on how to properly grow this plant, cultivate this plant, so that this plant can grow at its maximum potential and be, you know, the thing that you envision this plant to be. The same goes for love. Self-love, love in a relationship, love for friends, family. You want to make sure that the love that you're seeking and the love that you want to give out, especially when it comes to self-love and love for a relationship. You want to make sure that your soul, your energy, your life is free and clear of any kind of toxins, any kind of baggage, any kind of demons that you feel that you're not addressing, you're not attacking, you're letting dwell, you're not dealing with. You want to remove all those things. You want to give yourself the best chance to be love and receive love in every sense of the word. Because love heals, love is nurturing, love is the safety net when life just beats you up and spits you out. Love from friends, love from family, self-love, motivating yourself, clearing out your soul so that you can receive the love from God and the universe. That's what love is in its purest, highest sense to me. That's what love is supposed to be. The thing that brings you joy and the thing that allows you to keep your joy in your life when so many things and so many people are trying to rob you of it. That's what love is to me. Love is not supposed to hurt. It's only supposed to hurt if you're tearing down something that wasn't working for you, that was blocking you of your blessings to rebuild something back up. That's the pain that love should cause, only because you're trying to better yourself. Love is not supposed to abuse you, confuse you. You're not supposed to question if the love you're receiving is real. You're not supposed to question if you have enough inside of you to give out love. You're not supposed to question that, because if you're clearing the deck, if you're putting in the work to love yourself, if you're standing fast in your prayer and your meditation and removing people that are not giving you the sustainable nutrients to help you grow, to help you mature into the highest form of self that you can reach, that's not love. And all it does is leave you more in a state of just overall feeling lost and weak and helpless, trying to figure out the answers of why this is not happening, or why I'm not with this person, or why I'm not. It's because you don't have the right tools. You're not giving yourself the proper self-love so that you can be loved. You're not seeing clearly so that you can see who's really giving you the love that you're giving out and who's not really about that life. So for me, what I think love is just that love. It's supposed to be those things. Period. Period.